So, you finally come. I have long awaited your arrival, friend. And now that you're here, it's time. Time to get into the scares.
There's an old story about the tunnels under Shadyside High. Some kids used to party down there back in the 60s. Until something horrible happened. Something that left a bunch of people dead. It's just a story, right? There's nothing to be afraid of. Besides, exploring the tunnels is a lot more fun than being stuck in Saturday detention. And it's not as if anything could be down there. But something is. Something dark. Evil. And no longer human. Too bad there's no turning back. And no one is around to hear your screams.
It's been a long time since we've talked about children's horror novellas, and since Goosebumps has dried up, I've had to find a new series to cover. Of course, R.L. Stine has plenty of other series to go into. We've got Goosebumps 2000, we've got Goosebumps Horrorland, Goosebumps Choose Your Own Adventure, we got Goosebumps Out the Ass. But you know what? I decided, why don't we take a dive into R.L. Stine's other non-Goosebump-related affairs. And so I've come across something a lot of people don't exactly remember too well, because it was made for an older audience, and therefore was much, much darker. Today, I'll be going over Fear Street. Unfortunately, unlike Goosebumps, I don't have all the Fear Street books, so I won't be starting from the beginning, but rather a erratic order, based on the ones I remember the most, and then we'll go into ones I don't remember so well, and ones that I don't know at all. So this will be an interesting discovery into the other R.L. Stine novels.
We follow the story of a girl named Elaine as she begins Saturday detention for missing too many homework assignments. She's nervous about her first time in detention, as she has no idea what type of people she'll be meeting inside. As she trudges out of the school parking lot, she meets with their new principal, Mr. Savage, who takes her to the classroom where she is expected to waste her Saturday. As Elaine had expected, there were many kids in the detention classroom. Some she recognized, some she wished she didn't. In the front row was Jerry, a boy who was sent to detention for refusing to dissect a frog. And then there was the punk rocker girl, Darlene, who skipped too many days of class. Max, a heavyset boy that was pretty handy with a can of spray paint. And, of course, there was Beau, a kid that was so bad, the book constantly has to remind you of how bad he is. As Mr. Savage leaves the class, Beau hurls a knife towards his head, which fortunately misses, but says a lot about the character Beau and what deranged things he might be willing to do. Eventually, the kids get tired of waiting around the classroom, and with no supervision, they decide to go off and explore the school. While wandering around the halls, the kids duck inside the auditorium, where Elaine accidentally stumbles upon the entrance to a network of deep tunnels buried very deep beneath the school. rescued by her fellow detentionees, Beau reveals that this was once a bomb shelter that was built far beneath the school during the Cold War. However, the shelter was never used, and would become Party City for the teens of Shadyside High. But unfortunately, something bad happened. There was a collapse, and a few kids died. Afterwards, the tunnels were sealed off, and the location of them became lost to time. Until now, with nothing better to do, the kids decide to explore the network of dark tunnels full of garbage, rats, and mass amounts of flooding. And this is where they stumble upon a wall that had been sealed for years. And when the kids examine the wall more closely, and chip away at some of the mortar holding it together, the wall collapses, revealing a mysterious, deadly red mist. And one by one, the mist begins killing the kids as they find themselves trapped in these dark, spooky tunnels. Elaine and her newfound friends attempt to escape the tunnels, only to find that the ladder they had used to enter the tunnels was no longer available to be used. And so the Shadyside detentionees found themselves trapped. Trapped in miles of concrete tunnels. Trapped with dwindling light to show the way. Trapped with an unspeakable monster that is capable of unimaginable feats. Fear Street books are a lot more graphic than Goosebumps books can be. And believe me when I say this book happens to be a lot more graphic than most. When the mist grabs a hold of a character within this story, their death is very violent and very detailed. Our leading character, Elaine, will go through a lot throughout this story, as will many of the other characters as they fight to survive. The way the characters will learn to function and work together will be one of the interesting aspects of this story. But also, added upon it, is the mystery that this story offers, which keeps the reader invested. And this story will have many dark turns and dark twists within it. However, this story would fall short to me with its ending, for it felt a little bit rushed, like a lot of the Goosebump books I've covered prior. We get a very interesting character arc with Elaine and one of the characters, Beau, and I really would have been interested to see where that goes. But besides those two characters, the rest don't really offer too much. Our remaining survivors near the end of the book discover a secret chamber locked away under piles of rubble. Within this chamber, they discover six skeletons, to which they have assumed have either died from suffocation or starvation. These bodies are the bodies of students that were trapped in there years ago. On the wall, they notice the names of these students, but one of them catches their eye. An extra, added name. Not with the rest of the six. Scott Savage. The very Mr. Savage that was their current principal. And so, the group is once again attacked by the mist, but this time Elaine gets a good glance at the mist itself, and notice that it isn't a mist, but it's a flurry of faces. Red, angry faces. The mist was the amalgamated ghosts of the people trapped in that tunnel years ago. Barely escaping with their lives, Elaine and Beau run into Mr. Savage, who offers a way out of the tunnels, but sacrifices himself to the mist, realizing that they're the long-dead ghosts of his dear, dear friends. And so the mist takes Mr. Savage and crumples him up into a little tiny ball of blood and gore. Satisfied with their revenge, the ghosts dissipate, leaving Elaine and Beau to exit the tunnel together. Now that's one hell of a way to skip detention. The Fear Street Saga is a very interesting selection of books, and since it's written for an older audience, there will be a lot more graphic themes in it involving sex and violence. However, it's still not that bad, all things considered,
And I will have to say, out of all the Fear Street books I remember, this one happens to be the best in my book, as it actually deals with monsters and ghouls, which a lot of the Fear Street books, unfortunately, don't.
At the time of this review, I don't recall a lot of the Fear Street books, so I'll have very little to compare it to. After reading this novella, I would have to say that it does a very good job at holding your attention. It's definitely not a boring book. I enjoy the supernatural aspects of the book, but I also enjoy the characters and how they learn to work together and survive, even if it doesn't last too long. However, my only downfall for me when it comes to this novella is the fact that the ending feels a little bit rushed, and we never see a conclusion with the character arc that is Elaine and Beau, as Beau kind of learns to become more of a leader for the group.
He takes responsibility for his actions, and he learns to fight for the group. He even starts to care for Elaine. And I found all of this pretty interesting for such a short book. And I complain about the ending because it's simply resolved as soon as they leave the tunnels, and I was kind of curious to see where their relationship would go after surviving such an event like that. But I suppose all of that isn't really a huge issue in the grand scheme of things, as like I said, this is an enjoyable book. So overall, I would have to give this a 9 out of 10. If you're looking to get into Fear Street, check out this one first. Trust me, it won't disappoint.
Of course, if I had to compare this to anything, I'd say it's a horror version of The Breakfast Club, and that alone is a perfect way to get anybody into this book. I hope you all enjoyed this review, and please consider staying for the rest of the Fear Street books that I'll be covering this month. And thank you for watching. And I mean that sincerely. Thank you. Without you, I wouldn't have any reason to do this. Stay tuned for our next episode, where we'll be talking about a mysterious orb, one you may have seen, that often rises in the sky and brings strange creatures to light. See you there.